McConnell guy alluded to, the international, the biggest prize that all the Dota teams search for has yet to be won twice by any team or any player. In this series, this is really where the race, the first to two, if you will, begins. Prepare Evil Geniuses facing up against newbie TI5 winners versus TI4 and even a TI2 winner in the face of Chuan match up against each other to keep their hopes alive in the winner's bracket. Despite such a storied history between these two teams, their exact strength and weaknesses in the bracket remain a bit of a mystery.
Yeah, especially since both teams haven't really played a lot coming into this. We saw EG a little bit at Star Ladder. Newbie's been almost a complete mystery. It's kind of hard to judge just based on the group play alone. Newbie looked kind of mediocre, but a lot of teams said that they were strong coming into this event. EG was kind of the opposite, where based off of Star Ladder, you could say that they looked a little bit shaky and they just haven't had a lot of time to gel. But since the group stages, this team has looked like a well-oiled machine.
So which version of these two teams will we see? Will we see the newbie that was dominating and being top three in every single one of the premier tournaments going into TI? Or we will see the Evil Geniuses that has risen up going into the group stage and has managed to get themselves into the winner's bracket? Now, we're going to start things off. Evil Geniuses heading up to that top side, trying to secure Samael, an easy Bannerune. Newbie will control bottom. Looks like there's not going to be too much of a contest here. Our lanes should be fairly normal, right? Zyde's going to be backing up Samael, I presume, in the mid lane, trying to get that Storm Cure the biggest jump possible. That's what you referred to earlier, right, in the previous series, how Draw Ranger matched with the Storm Spirit is what allows him to have a good laning phase. You need to be able to have that extra bit of health for a Storm.
Yeah, especially since Storm relies heavily on getting those first three items as fast as possible. Just the Bloodstone alone on this hero doesn't really make him threatening. It's really just the potential to zip across the map, pick somebody off with the Orchid, then just immediately get out. Getting that second defensive item post-Bloodstone is going to be really important in this game, especially if he's going to have any chance of surviving against some of these heroes. As I'd imagine a BKB or a Lincoln's is going to be what he goes for third. Even Radiant's something like a Shiva's could really help him greatly against both the Slaughter and the Elder Titan.
Now, Zai had the idea here to be up in the top lane and stack up for the Batrider, that offlane camp. Unfortunately, to his dismay, he's going to discover that that one has just been blocked out by Chuan's counter ward laid out. So, no easy farm for Universe to be able to recover from. Meanwhile, Newbie are actually running a much more active offlane of their own with KP and Kaka facing up against Fear and PPD, matching a 2 versus 2.
Right now, it doesn't really look like Fear is going to get too much out of this lane. Both the Elder Titan and the Slaughter are such strong laners, especially in the early phase. PPD should just pull, try to get levels. Sort of abandoning trying to trade hits with these two heroes. They're not really going to take that much damage, and up at top, Zai trying to secure Universe's farm a little bit, trying to take advantage of the fact that Shadow Demon and Slark in the early phases aren't too strong.
Once again, Chuan, stymieing the plans of Evil Geniuses, manages to stop the pull over. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, Kaka beginning to get aggressive. Zai has come in, will be tethered up to Fear to give him that extra bit of movement speed. The stun goes out, doesn't hit KP as well. The stomp by Kaka, is that going to be enough to be able to get him away? Stuns him all up, another right click comes out from PPD. Looks like Fear is going to have to throw out the Storm Hammer. One more second, he's got the mana now. Kaka goes for the deny on Roshan, but they're both stunned together. And Fear will cleave Kaka to death for the first blood.
That was the best possible scenario, as Roshan couldn't deny him as he was stunned up as well. Oh, she even going to deny that range creep, and a very decent start for EG.
Absolutely. If you look at mid, Samael's doing quite well for himself. 12-1, though he is out of mana now. Do have the courier funneling in the double bottles, though. So we're going to see Samael go right back up to full HP and full mana.
And this should be a relatively free matchup for Storm, as thrives against these melee heroes that can't really contest them or have kill potential against them. And we're seeing that already as quite early 15 CS at just 2 minutes into the game. Whereas Mew struggling to break double digits right now.
Now, the Elder Titan, he had some impact in the bottom lane, but it also meant that he fed away first blood. The Storm Spirit is getting so much space in the mid lane. Is this where we start thinking about Newbie perhaps rotating both the Shadow Demon and the Elder Titan to try and gank up that Storm Spirit? Or is that just a little bit too much out of the realm of possibility?
I don't think you have to do that quite yet, because the good thing about DK is Storm has quite a hard time killing him once you get a few levels of that Dragon's Blood, which he already has two of. High armor heroes are something that Storm really dislikes. And I think Sumail's the type of player anyways that will try to prioritize farm in a game like this, because he should rightly believe that he's the best late game hero in this game.
In which case, probably better to try and secure Hal's farm, as he doesn't want to be left alone against a Batrider, at least not until he has his level 6. So Kaka will remain in the bottom lane with KP, trying to ensure this Slardar has a good start. This is pretty much newbie through and through. They want to be able to enable KP to have a an early blink dagger on most of his offlane heroes and get his initiation in early.
Yeah, the Slardar is going to be huge to countering the Storm. Like Winter talked about on the panel, it's one of the best ways to deal with that Storm Spirit, but if Storm just gets a little bit of farm, he can get his Bloodstone timing at a decent time, especially if, to that step before, the Slardar picks up Blink Dagger, he might just always have enough to survive, even with the SD disruption.
Universe has been trying to bully Hal back as much as possible. He dove past the Tier 1 tower, as we saw, and TP back for his Tranquil Boots, so he is off to a damn good start. A lot of that being helped out by Zai's Wisp. Now going to be looking towards the mid lane. Both these heroes about to pick up their level 6. This is where potential kills could happen. Both these heroes are still rather tanky. Dragonite, of course, has that heavy amount of armor, and Samael, he's got that Zip Zap. I don't really think they have the strong enough supports to really burst down a Storm Spirit off the Dragonite Dragontail.
They might, but at the same time, it's going to be a pretty heavy investment. They are making their way forward, trying to get Samael before he hits level 6, but they might not be successful in that. And on top of that, Samael already has a Magic Wand, one of the best investments you can make defensively on a Storm, and he's going to pick up an Infused Raindrop on the way. So that should make it nearly impossible for him to die, but they are making the move forward.
They're going to put it to the test. Not
doesn't have that
level 6
yet.
Ooh. Hey, just a little poke there, but not quite the follow-up in time from the supports. They may try again when Mu completes his level 6, but for now, they will head back up to the top lane. They also have to consider that not only all those defensive items you were talking about, Magic Wand, they even have Zai ready to go at any point with a tethered model. So making that attempted play at mid may turn against them quickly.
Yeah, they just wanted to try to get aggressive before Storm hits level 6. They were going to try to lead that into some tower damage early on mid. That's the best advantage of having a Dragon Knight in this matchup, is that then EG have to rotate maybe one of the two supports. They have to deal with that, then you free up this bottom lane. But as a result, Mu gets denied. Sumail's just going to continue to free farm. He's already almost up to 40 CS at under 6 minutes. Unbelievable for any mid hero, much less a Storm.
He seems to be not fazed at all by that breathe fire damage reduction, as the extra hits from Overload granting him easy CS opportunities. Does this mean, do you think Evil Geniuses, they're getting the best out of the laning phase? Are you still okay with newbie still protecting Hal and not trying to put too much pressure on mid?
I think they have to protect Hal because this early game is going to really determine how much real estate they can get.
Yeah.
Because the way that it works right now is that newbie, they have to take care of this dire jungle, and they need a hero that can kind of roam around this top area, which is going to be your Slark, to deny a lot of the Storm's farm.
Bit of pressure on Mu. They're going to be a whole lot more pressure soon, as PPD is going to wrap around with the rest of the supports coming in, as well as Universe. Mu is going to be the target here, but already the defensive supports of newbie are going to respond with extra TP. They manage to latch on a Universe with the pounce. He will be the first one down. The rest of Evil Geniuses retreat. In fact, they may even lose PPD. Looks like KP has his sights on the Winter Wyvern. Already has the amp damage on him. No escape for PPD. That'll be a step here. He'll go in their way unless Fear can somehow stop it, but he realizes there is no way. And KP pops the mango, and Slithering Crush will seal the deal. 1-2 now to the favor of newbie.
KP already has 1500 gold at 7 short minutes into this game. He's had quite a successful offlane as a result of having Kaka pretty much camp this area for him, then contesting this Sven plus Winter Wyvern, but
I mean, it feels like that was almost, in a way, a test from Evil Geniuses trying to go for a dive on the mid lane, because we've seen, more so than any other team, I would say, newbie know how to play defensively around those early laning ganks. They always are set up with defensive supports behind their mid, and they usually are going to mass rotate to punish you.
You pointed that out before this game as well, that we are going to see this counter-aggressive play from newbie. We got a taste of that there, as Universe not having nearly as good of a time as this Slardar is when it comes to his timings. Blink for him is going to be pretty delayed as a result of that mid attempt, but again, Sumail is going to be the hero to watch in this game. From a Storm player perspective, this is a very good timing for him right now, and the type of heroes that newbie has, you just eat them alive.
Denied! Which means it is going to be all the more critical for KP to finish up that Blink Dagger and get a successful gank on mid, coupled with Dragonite.
The thing about KP, though, is he's going to have his work cut out for him this game. He's going to almost always have to be the scouting force for this Slark. Tau alone just doesn't deal enough damage, especially with the Winter Wyvern, so...
Right.
He is going to be in a situation where he might pick up that early Blink, but he always has to worry about falling behind in relative farm. If you only gank with the Slardar, you just get behind. You don't want to be in a position where at 25 minutes you only have a 4-staff and a Blink Dagger. You want to start building towards those core items and treating yourself like a third core.
Now, coming forward here with the Invis, he's going to get a quick surprise initiation on the move. Just a small pittance of damage. Nothing life-threatening, but does force a rotation out of newbie.
Curious to see what build Sumail decides to go for. Does have enough money for treads, but there is a lot to be said about going just straight for the Bloodstone this game and grabbing the Arcane Boost.
Newbie. Two supports sitting behind Mu. They have Hao with his level 7, actually level 8, about to be picked up. So they know he's going to be okay there. And KP, his lane is being pushed out. In fact, they're going to try and enable KP even more. An early invasion into the jungle. Classic Dota strategy at this point. I mean, they see PPD picked out, but it looks like they are going to be able to get the initiation on him with a fresh Blink Dagger picked up by KP. All PPD could do is maybe get the Cold Embrace off, but not even that goes down. A third kill going the way of newbie, and they may be set up to push in that tier 1 tower. Evil Geniuses, though, pretty quick with the response. They're already pushing in the mid lane and forcing Kaka to defend.
You saw how far Fear was away from that attempt, I think. G was kind of aware of that happening, but they were banking on allowing their Winter Wyvern to kind of soak up that gank for them. Newbie don't really transition that into anything, which is probably the bigger part here, is during that time period, you just had Storm farm, you had Batrider continue to farm, your Sven was getting the jungle as well, and Newbie, all they really get out of it is this level 5 Winter Wyvern, who hasn't had a lot of farm, has 628 net worth, they barely get anything out of that gank. Might have not even been really worth their time.
Let's talk about that philosophy a little bit. Our time together, you oftentimes encourage me to completely abandon that lane, don't even leave a support there for levels. While we've seen, you know, some teams do take that philosophy, others are willing to leave a support there and sort of tanks the gank in some way. It basically kind of sets up a situation where the team smoking and evading does get that extra little bit of gold and experience. What are your thoughts on it, and what do you think that really means Evil Genius's plans are for this game?
I think for EG, it's simply just if the gank happens at that south side of the map, then you free up time and space for your Storm, because the Storm is the real hero of this game. If Winter Wyvern dies 10 times, they can still win this game just on the fact that this hero can get huge. Right now, he's progressing very nicely. He's already got 1,800 gold. This Batrider's not doing too bad either. Sven, who's going to really get ahead. All the pressure is on newbie right now. EG can play proactively by moving around the map, but they don't have to force engagements, whereas newbie they have to, because you've got neutral things that EG can just take control of, like this aim cap right now. That fear has already stacked 3 times into this game. Storm's just going to keep farming his jungle, so newbie, every single time they show themselves as 3 and they pop the dragon form, that means you can't really make a move right after that. You're going to have to wait to cooldowns, you're going to have to wait to reset the map, and the Slardar. Look at his item build. He just went straight for the Blink Dagger. He's got no Tranquils or anything like that. He's going to struggle pretty heavily just constantly rotating. I mean, he delivered himself a Clarity, but he still only has 500 HP and AP. He's got his work cut out for him in a game like this.
So that kind of investment in ganking that bottom lane is essentially just a big distraction for Evil Geniuses to get more space. That Dragon Form being popped, the rotation, the smoke being used, it all means that Sumail will feel comfortable pushing aggressively and getting that extra bit of farm. He may even see a rotation through the dire jungle and starts getting some extra golden experience out of that. Newbie already trying to keep as much damage off that tier 1 mid tower with the early rotation by Kaka. This obviously, that mid tower, pretty important for dire side, right? It helps you control that Roshan pit, which is a possibility if Evil Geniuses win a good fight. More than likely, though, Newbie should be able to claim the.
I think the interesting part here is that what usually happens with this 10-minute play is you'll almost always see in any competitive game right now, Dire has any sort of pressure mid-hero, they're going to make their way down into this Radiant Jungle, get one ward down, maybe even behind the tower, a full commitment of that, and you simply just take down this bottom tower and you just own half of the map, but as a result of probably just being afraid of the Storm farming, the Dragon Knight instead makes his rotation of this bottom rune and I think he just wants to try to shut this down because he knows that Kaka is liable to be dived because he's a level 4 Elder Titan.
Yeah. trying to make sure that Samael doesn't get the space required. Zanubi obviously then would have equal incentive to try and take down that mid tower. What do you think the game plan coming up in the next 10 minutes is for them?
I think for Nubi, it's continue to get aggressive across the map. What I'd really like to see them do is maybe even make a smoke play for this top lane, try to pick off Universe and transition that into allowing one of the two supports on Nubi to get some farm while Slark, once he grabs his Shadowblade, just roams around the map and creates a lot of space. Best thing that Slark does right now in this meta and why he's come back in such force is he just owns such a significant part of the map. There's no way that even a single support is willing to move around the map when you've got a Slark with a Shadowblade, and so they have to clump together, slow down their own timings, and you can't just always cover yourself with sentries.
Right. The investment. We are going to see our on pause finally. 10-minute mark comes through.
Oh, he does make his way bottom again. So that's what I was curious about, whether or not he would do this.
Change up their mind. They will go for that tier 1 tower. Evil Genius is getting plenty out of it, though. As we said, Samael making his way through the jungle, trying to get that extra bit of boost. And same goes with Fear. He cleared through the ancient stack. Obviously, Universe is having a decent time as well, trying to complete that drum. So all three cores of Evil Geniuses are getting something out of this pressure from Nubi at the bottom lane, and the tier 1 tower isn't even going to fall immediately. They seem a bit scared with so many heroes of Evil Geniuses off map.
Yeah, but Nubi should just assume that there's a lot of farming going around. And if you look at EG's commitment to farm, you notice that Sumail's gone for the Arcane Boots build, which has kind of seen a resurgence. Or was always described as mid cock.
There's the dive on mid.
Worried about.
A level 5 Elder Titan isn't much to Samael, but with the extra TPs, they will be buffed. And now the stun comes in from KP. They're going to go straight for the Zai. He's got to relocate, but it's not going to be fast enough. He goes down and down into stun of Samael. Do they have the damage? No, not quite. The Slithering Crush. Half a second too late. KP had to be spamming that one out, but relying on cooldowns, they will not be able to get the big core of Evil Geniuses.
Very well done by Nubi, though. They are utilizing this Blink Dagger on this Stardard very well. This is the kind of engagement that they need, but if you just look at the passive gold going on right now, EG still ahead on their two cores.
Yeah, you can say that mid setup where they're able to kill the Wisp, yeah, they saved the Elder Titan, but it cost them their tier 1 tower at bottom lane that they were pushing earlier. PPD did manage to get the deny on that, so that is obviously, gold exchange-wise, not really going to be real good for Nubi. AP trying to set up again on the mid lane, but they can get another pick. When are we going to look towards Roshan and that Aegis?
I think even more important than the Roshan is for Nubi to try to control this ancient area. If they control this ancient area right now, I'd say that the pace of the game right now for them is very good, and they're satisfied, but as a result of this kind of going uncontested, it doesn't matter if EG lose one support hero, the cost of Sven just farming three ancient stacks and storm farming out the jungle. It means that your two cores are distributing farm very well.
Well, surely things are about to amp up as Nubi are completing that Shadowblade, flying it out to Hao now. Yep. And they're going to go for a four-man smoke, actually meeting Hao's lane. They're going to go
we just talked
that
about
ancient
this.
Stack.
They have to control this area. Dire's
bottom tower is surely under they attack. Won't be able to actually catch anyone
Radiant's
farming that
top
stack.
Tower is under attack.
They will be able to block it away. That was move.
It should transition, though. This top tower is worth it for them to go for in full force. But instead, they're going to go all the way around, it looks like. Don't want to get caught out. This is a smart move. Control this ancient area. They got two wards down in this section. Now they're going to know when the stack happens.
Well, Geniuses, they kind of had two choices there. They could have actually pressured that mid-tier one tower, or try and contest top lane. This four-man smoke looks like they didn't quite fully know that Nubi was going to go for the tower, and they decide against contesting and just start setting up for the tier 1 mid, seeing that it's the higher objective.
Yeah. For EG, I think getting into team fights early on, unless you can start out with a numbers advantage, is going to be difficult. And you don't really want to slow down the
tower. Now the stunning two-man Slithering Crush. That's going to set up Hao. He'll be able to get the pounce. Oh no! He got bounced back by the Flame Break, misses the pounce because of it. And now won't be able to get the immediate damage onto Fear, so instead he turns to PPD. Will be able to pop him out. Samael goes to the back.
Running out of mana.
He's getting low. Will be able to make that last long jump into
okay,
the river.
He's got
but
the
now
stun
he's right there with the amplified damage, and they don't even need a Slithering Crush there. They'll get a second one too. Perhaps Zai gets the tether away, but he wants this pursuit. Managed to get another two-man Slithering Crush. Zai with the amplified damage is fresh meat for Nubi, and they're going to claim the Batrider's life as well. Four down from Evil Geniuses, and Nubi will push mid.
That was so well done by Newbie as they set that fight up perfectly. They had all the time in the world to flank from every single angle. Sumail just going a bit too hard for that Shadow Demon right there. He just did not have the damage with his build. And I was just about to say, they want to try to avoid fights when your Storm is so close to his Bloodstone. But instead, they're just going to lose so many heroes on the back of that. On top of that, now their Inky Sacks are slowed down.
The initiations from KP is really what set all that up. That two-man Slithering Crush. The miss pounce was unfortunate for Newbie, but it didn't cost them much. Sumail, he committed towards that backline, didn't have the mana to be able to get it all the way across the river, and got stuck inside. Evil Geniuses looked like a game plan that was sort of cobbled together last second as Newbie find the successful initiation.
Yeah, they're going to go back to this mid tower. They still have a lot of these ultimates up. The Winner's Curse is available to them, but they've got to be careful. They can't take two consecutive... another consecutive fight like that, because Sumail, again, closing in on that Bloodstone. I think you want to wait for it, but they're going to smoke, try to secure this mid tower, and they've got to be careful for this one. Newbie, I think they're itching to fight. Got all their spells available to them.
Maybe Evil Geniuses think they're going to catch Newbie off guard. This aggressive play, pre-Bloodstone.
They're wrapping all the way around.
Newbie are pretty grouped up. Here comes the full-on sandwich. They are going to get a two-man Stormbolt coming out from Fear with the cleave. They'll take out both. Universe, controlled up by the Cold Embrace, will be able to save his life long enough to be able to get the last out now on the move. Getting some extra damage onto Hal, trying to stay ahead of him. Hal gets out, but three down from Newbie, making four. KP caught by the Stormbolt. And now it's Evil Genius's turn to reap the reward.
Unbelievable read by Aegeus. Fear just assaults the support duo from Newbie. They weren't able to get a single spell off. If they were able to slow him with the Demonic Purge, disrupt themselves, maybe they would have been able to win that fight. I think Newbie was favored, but that was the perfect engagement from EG. They immediately take out the two supports. You can't write it better than that, as now Sumail gonna pick up that Bloodstone, and EG are gonna reset into a very good position.
I mean, if you look at the initiation of Evil Geniuses, the Storm Spirit, Batrider, Winter Wyvern, all these heroes are excellent at being able to set up teamfights for success, but Newbie's biggest strength is these very disruptive, defensive-style supports in both the Shadow Demon and Elder Titan. Both of them have a way to kind of stall up your aggression, to put a pause on the game while that disruption or that stomp binds time and resets the fight for Newbie. But when you're able to assault that back line like Fear did, take out full supports, as you said, before they cast a single spell. Fight looks rather easy for Evil Geniuses now. Set up for another team fight. 5-9, 17 minutes in. Evil Genius.
Here has the Blink Dagger. Newbie's got to be careful, but I think that... that was pretty unbelievable. It looked like both the Newbie supports weren't sure where the Stormbolt was going to go, so they both froze. They stood right next to each other. They can't afford to do that, and I think they're going to prioritize the safety of them now, as Mu is going to frontline for them with that armlet. Very hard to take down, but EG, they've got the Blink Dagger on this Fen, and they want to utilize it.
Newbie going to make it as hard as possible for Evil Geniuses to find a successful initiation. Look at their positioning. Hard right side of the map, sitting inside the trees. Still not too grouped up where Stormbolt could catch multiple heroes. So, Evil Geniuses, they're going to have their work cut out for them in order to get the initiation needed. And that's why they're actually going to back out. And this is actually fully tipped off by Newbie. Great scan will see the retreat of Evil Geniuses and their rotation through the jungle and towards mid and top.
And EG didn't get really anything out of that. They cleared out their jungle, so if Newbie decided to make an aggressive move, find anything.
Double damage!
Everybody from EG should make a full-on retreat. Should just continue to farm up these two camps as well on the two cores. Sumail can start establishing himself up in this camp as well. Newbie just want to continue to get aggressive with this Blink Dagger on the Slardar. We talked about how this hero, he might just turn into a fighter, not get enough farm, and slowly start to get behind, and trying to see that here.
B. Reaching that point. Right initiation could turn into safe for them, but it's actually going to be the Fear who finds the first stun out. KP responds of course. So they're in crunch down. Kaka gonna be saved for the moment by Quan. An interruption will only buy a moment's respite though. And now it's going to be Evil Geniuses running over Newbie one by one. KP, he's gonna be next target while Universe pulling back Mu. KP, he'll definitely die. Fear with God Strength cleans him up, and PPD manages to survive against Hao's assault. Tried to go for the back line just like Fear did, but wasn't nearly as successful.
I mean, this game plan from EG to consistently just go for the supports, pick up these free Bloodstone charges on Sumail, this is really what's going to enable them to scale, and I mean, the crowd senses it right now. EG is playing so well around their two cores.
Now Newbie is going to have to go back to just farming away. As Mu pushing out that bottom lane, Hao going to take his part in top lane. Mu's got 2100 gold here. He already has the armlet. What is the next item for him? Does he need more defensive style BKB?
I might even think of picking up a Blink Dagger of his own just because they lack some initiation right now on Newbie. I think Newbie is a team that desperately needs to start playing aggressively. That's two fights in a row now where just been found out very quickly, and he does go for the Blink Dagger like we noticed.
Call.
Yeah. Move. KP though, like 270 gold right now in a position where he had something like a 9-minute Blink Dagger. This is not the kind of progression that you need to see, especially against a Storm who's scaling so fast.
They need a successful fight, or at least a pickoff.
They need one fight into a Roshan right now for Newbie to get back into this game comfortably.
Genius is keeping themselves pretty well spread, feeling comfortable with their rate of farm so far. Yes, Arcelark is top of the net worth board, but not by much. Both the Sten and the Storm Spirit are just barely trailing it. Now looks like Newbie are going to find that initiation. They're going to jump on the universe first. They don't quite have the burst damage, though. Zai's going to be able to come in with the tether, help save him, while KP is going to be jumped on by Samael, easily taken out. Fear turns, finds out Mu. Hao's coming in for the Zai, but once again, he's being distracted by PPD, and PPD shoots him right out. Now has to go for Fear instead, but Zai, he's causing problems, detailing up Fear, and Fear's beating him out. Now. Hao's not going to be able to make it away from this one. Fight right back, and Zai survives. Quad down as well. Newbie lose 4, and it's Evil Geniuses who will take the Roshan.
I guess that answers how good EG is. 3 fights in a row now as they go for the relocate.
Oh, they want the fit. They don't want Roshan. They're going to take all 5. That's a wipe. Elder Titan down. Newbie goes straight for the tier 1. They keep up the pace. They don't let Newbie have anything extra. And now the Blink Daggers start swarming in. Universe, he picks up his own. Let's see that one again. They tried to jump on Universe, but the burst damage just wasn't quite there. And Samael's initiation was so much stronger than the full force of Newbie.
That was so well done by both of EG's supports, constantly kiting. PPD alone, Hao occupied for so long, they were able to just isolate targets out. You notice that Samael instantly jumps for that slaughter, getting rid of that counter initiation. And EG played this fight so well, they were so self-aware of where all their teammates were at all times. Newbie, they cannot afford to take fights like that. That's a 20 Bloodstone charge Storm that almost has that Orchid, and he's going to render 3 of these heroes on Newbie's side completely useless.
Newbie, gotta be feeling a bit desperate now and unsure how to approach this. They keep on trying to get the right fights, and they find what seems to be a pretty good initiation each time, but seems to turn against Evil Geniuses, as they just seem to have the right response in the form of both Samael and PPD, the defensive and offensive side.
I don't even know who you call the MVP so far in EG. All of their cores have been playing really well. The two supports occupied Newbie's cores for such a long period of time. Newbie just unable to chain together spells as a result of this Storm Spirit, who's creating so much chaos in these fights. Vaughn and Quark are just trying to keep up, seeing what they can do, but around the map is a little bit too fast for them right now. Is EG gonna go smoke again? They want to go for team fight number 4. Maybe they can even get a Roshan of themselves, which on the Storm Spirit would make them pretty much untouchable.
Yeah, this Orchid, this could be big. 20 Bloodstone charges.
They're gonna find Mu. Moment. They're gonna be able to find Mu. Pulling back. KP couldn't give a stop. The Slithering Crush not there. Now the long jump in from Samael. Grabs Kaka. No defensive support play there. He gets stunned up, but Samael is gonna receive some help from Zai. Starts zipping around. Samael's gonna be fine. The Cold Embrace buys him a little bit of healing time, and Hao has to run himself away. But Samael, quick on this jump forward, is gonna be able to save. Nice Winter's Curse out. Samael was a bit too far forward. Now they're gonna be able to get the Orchid out. Hao surely dead. Unable to be saved by anybody from Newbie Chuan.
Oh, they're gonna go
for the Samael. He just keeps on running in. The regeneration. He has so much mana to work with, and he just doesn't stop.
This is how you play a Storm Spirit. Samael's just giving a masterclass to the other two players so far in this main stage who have failed with it. This is the hero that made his name famous. Radiant's bottom tower. He is doing it proud right now. Level 16 Storm, 23 Bloodstone charges. Like, this guy's pretty much unstoppable.
And he's already got 2k gold in the bank. you'll have that third item. You were really pumping that up. The third item for Storm Spirit is really where he truly comes online.
He's already kind of come online, and with the third item, Shiva's, Lincoln's, both of them have merit. He's going to go for either the Hex or the Lincoln's for himself. If he goes for the Lincoln's, I think Newbie have almost no hope of stopping this guy.
I mean, look at Newbie's items. They went for Echo Saber on the Slark. They went the Blink Dagger on the Dragonite. Slardar still has no progression past the Blink Dagger that he picked up rather early on in the game. These heroes committed pretty heavily towards being able to contest and even win Evil Geniuses in that 20-minute, 15-20-minute area. And it didn't work out for them, and now they're just not going to see the kind of mid-to-late-game progression that they had ID'd.
And EG allowing Newbie to filter into them. They know that Newbie's desperate for a fight right now. Everything that Newbie has done so far in terms of their build has itemized for the mid-game. KP at one point had 200 gold about 5 minutes ago, now has 500, and they're in a position where they're just forced to smoke right now. They don't have a lot of Radiant's options. They might even decide to go for the Roshan, but in that pit is waiting. There's a Heartbeat there, but instead they're going to try to get aggressive. EG on the opposite side of the map, reading this movement perfectly, and Newbie's going to get denied once again.
Smoke not going to last long enough for them to be able to make the long journey up to top lane. Get close, and Hal might be able to scout them out with the Shadow Blade, but it seems like Evil Genius is going to stay pretty tight-knit here, excluding Universe, who will trail a bit farther behind.
The worst thing when you play Storm is usually when there are two farm supports that you can't really do anything about and comfort them for each other, but
now
in this situation...
They found Doom, Abu, all by himself up the top rune! Godlike Samael!
Yeah, they could not protect anybody right now. Newbie, they've got to go full retreat mode. Is EG going to filter in?
Jump forward, Samael, looking for more.
Kind of low on mana though, he's got to be careful. They're just going to passively push out the top lane and dare Newbie to fight them. Newbie just getting further and further behind this. They've got to split up the map.
Okay, here's the tower will be taken by Evil Geniuses, and this will help Samael finish up his third item, which will be the Lincoln's, to stop the Dragon Tail of the Dragon Knight, who kind of all in committed with that Blink Dagger to try and shut out the Storm Spirit as fast as possible. A rapid rotation though, and a long jump from Samael finds Tuan, a perfect pickoff with that Orchid. Makes it look too damn easy for Evil Geniuses.
No support can survive anymore. He can just make those random jumps, find heroes around the map, play this style against a Storm who farmed anyways. 25 Bloodstone charges. He just continues to rack him up. Even if he dies, he'll almost instantly be back in the fight, because I can even bring him back. Just going to take all these outer towers, and it's not even like EG have a standard push lineup. It's just that they're so much stronger. Newbie has seen no item progression on any of their cores. Slardar, he'd be lucky to get something like a 35-minute 4-step at this point.
Evil Geniuses, while they may be playing aggressive, they're not giving any openings to Newbie. Relu came forward, is going to bring Zai back into this fight, where they get the tier 2. Universe already scouting out that Newbie are not going to contest this tier 2. Newbie pretty much have to hole up inside their base, it seems. As they really can't take a straight 5-on-5 anymore.
Problem for them though, again, is their itemization is to the fact that they kind of just have to go for these fights. It's not like their sword skill ultra well later into the game. Neither of them can do anything against the Storm Spirit. KP doesn't have the items to contest anymore. Problem is, there was a point where you could drop everything on Samael and you could probably take him down and maybe you could kite the rest of the heroes. But now this is a Storm Spirit with 2000 HP, 17 armor, and a Lincoln's. There is almost no chance that Newbie take him out, even if they isolate him 4-on-1.
Slark, that would normally want to go Scotty, forced into an Amantis-style position. Doesn't want to be caught out by that Orchid without Dark Pact already running in, so... An award going to be laid down. They are going to make their
long jump.
It's the secret shot they've already got. Kaka is going to be saved by the disruption, but instead, they'll take KP, flying and leave Kaka for slightly later. Mu going to be chased away by Universe, and Chuan will be the third pickup. Triple kill. Samael once more, running low on mana with the help of Fear. He can do it all the way into the tier 3 tower. Armlet toggling. Mu desperate to be able to get out of here, but not the case. An ultra kill for Samael as he balls out of control.
And Hal simply can't do anything as EG. They're definitely going to chase this hero. They want a 5-man wipe as now he's gonna go for the TP. Samael doesn't have anything left in the tank, but EG with so many team fights, one in a row, not a lot of hope for Newbie.
Tier 2 being assaulted, the last one of its kind for Newbie. And next stop, Evil Geniuses. Can they just in their hands and go high ground? Tell us this break. You could even see Evil Geniuses perhaps push high ground without it. They are in such a dominant position at this point.
EG, out of all the teams remaining, they look like they're going to be the closest to maybe repeating as TI champs, as they look so on point right now. They're going to move into this Roche pit. Newbie, again, they probably just have to face check into this to stop it.
That cold beat only growing bigger and bigger. Newbie are not going to go for the Roshan, it seems. Start pushing their way out into the dire jungle. Maybe they're not aware that it's Roshan time. Maybe they just don't think they can contest. Will opt to try and farm up what little they can in the meantime.
Everybody right now on Newbie is just like, he is just completely plateaued. They keep running around this five. They can't really afford to show themselves as individual heroes to push out lanes because of Storm. Now almost has this Bloodthorn available to him. Solo pickoff potential for him is so huge. And at some point, Newbie, they've got to come back and they've got to defend this. There's no opportunity for them to go for a skill push as Shadow Demon. That's about poison, but he doesn't want to get too close. Hold up support from Newbie. They've got to be careful.
They think they're hard up back, but there is no distance that the male will not go to pick a support off. He managed to grab Tuan Shadow Demon while Fear takes the tier 3 tower.
This has just been a miserable game for Newbie. They're going to call it pretty early, 25-9.
A Bloodthorn to finish things off. The male with 30 Bloodstone charges. The Storm Spirit is truly back in the meta on Evil Geniuses.
He just went completely unchecked, and out of all the teams that have run him so far in this tournament, he has made him look unbelievable.
Absolutely an electric performance by some.